Kahanamoku, better known as the Duke, is still regarded today as one of the world's greatest aquatic sportsmen of all time. Participant in 5 Olympic Games dating back to his gold medal performance in the 1912 competition in Stockholm, Sweden, this quiet-mannered, muscular Hawaiian beach boy from Waikiki captured the hearts and respect of countless generations of admirers from around the globe. The Duke taught us all the meaning of brotherhood and love. Of the many fans from around the globe, no stronger group exists than those who have grown up in Duke's own backyard, here in Hawaii.
I remember when I was a kid, Duke used to come out all the time just to go out for a paddle or take a swim by himself. It was mostly just to be alone, I think, with his thoughts in the ocean. He had this lifelong relationship with the ocean. It was quite unique, I think, for modern Hawaii, but quite natural to Duke.
Duke Kahanamoku was my neighbor. We lived in the duck ponds, about approximately 100 acres, all in swamps, with a series of date trees planted. Originally, that area was scheduled to be a date farm. It was supposed to be commercial. That location was on corner McCully and Kalakaua Avenue. And there was a streetcar that turns right smack at the corner. And we lived about 2 blocks away from Duke Kahanamoku. Yeah, he was living on the Paoa property, which they were related to. And Duke Kahanamoku was a very humble person and very, what I would call, a first-class Hawaiian.
Growing up with my famous brother, the whole family never took advantage of the name. I never have. I'm 76 today, proud of it, because we kept it clean. I came from a beautiful parent, mother and father. My mother came from the island of Kauai. She was the daughter of the high chief there. My father came from, I think it was Maui, Hawaii. And they were great parents. So they had 14 youngsters. I'm the 14th. I only knew 6 boys and 3 girls. But some died before Brother Duke and after. So the ones that lived through my lifetime was Brother Duke, David, Bernice, Bill, who we lost yesterday, Samuel, Kapiolani, Mariah, Louis, and myself. My brother Louis is over in the corner. My sister Bernice and Hilo. Well, when I grew up, yes, my brother Duke was the eldest, and I always had to listen to him. I always looked up to him.
I came over here in December 1938. I didn't meet Duke until about a month or so afterwards. I was introduced to him by his brother Sam. But I wanted to meet Duke because I had read about him when I was a little girl in school. I'd read about him in a movie magazine where he had been discovered by Douglas Fairbanks and Mary Pickford. When I heard the name Duke Kahanamoku, of course I couldn't pronounce it then, I had no idea how to pronounce it. I said, that's the man I want to meet. Well, I think I met all of his 5 brothers first, and little by little I met Duke. And it was love at first sight for Duke, which was very lucky for me.
There was one experience. We boated from here to Maui, overnight in Maui, and from Maui to the big island. The channel known as Alanui Haha Channel. You know, supposedly one of the roughest channels in the world when it's really, when it's real bad. And there were four of us. I mean, we were hanging on, trying to, you know, stay in the boat as much as we can because it was so rough. And Duke was just standing there like nothing was fazing him, you know? And he turned to us and said, "What's the matter, boy? It's too rough for you, you know?" And, but I tell you, that was a day I thought we were, you know, going to see the end of Hawaii. It was a scary experience, but Duke was very, you know, in control and didn't face him at all.
His favorite meal, his number one favorite food, was poi, a big bowl of poi, and a can of salmon, chilled. Open the can and get an onion and quarter the onion and the big bowl of poi, and that was his favorite meal, period. His second favorite was Argentine canned corned beef fried with onions. And again, a great big bowl of poi. Well, when I say a big bowl, I mean a big bowl like that. And those were his two favorites. But I started out with French cooking and trying to have all these different sauces and be very lovely. And he'd say, "Baby, where's the ketchup?" He always called me baby. He said, "Where's the ketchup?" And I said, "You can't put ketchup on that. That's a hollandaise sauce, or it's a, you know, sauce béarnaise, whatever." "Well, I like ketchup." Then finally he got to the point and he said, "Baby, just cook it plain."
Everything Duke did athletically was championship performance. His surfing ability, he was way beyond his time. Some of the things he did with a surfboard were profound in their day, considering also the equipment he was working with. When Duke was surfing as a young man in the earlier part of this century, he was surfing on surfboards that were 15 or 16 feet long and weighed 120 or 130 pounds. I'd venture to say that many kids nowadays couldn't even carry Duke's board to the water, much less surf it.
This is kind of a big wave now. Come up this way. Make your feet up that way. That way. Go left, go. Balance. Move up. The wave small, go forward. The wave big, you go back. And when you get back, you want to turn right, here you go. And that whole thing turns. You want to go left, you go. And all up, it's right in here.
Duke was so humble that it prevailed on me to be humble and be kind also. He was a man of tremendous stature, but very humble and down to earth. It was a rare quality, but among the Hawaiians, it was a quality of unusual strength.
Contemporary people, especially contemporary young people, to realize is that, that this name they hear, Duke Kahanamoku, was a real man. And he was a man that gained his respect and his honor in our society through just being a good man and not through being a capitalist or being a big businessman or being a talented, devoted, wonderful man. He was, in my estimation, the embodiment of aloha. He always, you know, Duke was the type of person who might have felt, had ill feelings about a subject or someone, but he never let you know about it. The guy always had a smile on his face and always a good word for everybody he met. He was not caught up in the modern day-to-day rat race that seems to consume so many people nowadays. He had, as I said earlier, a great sense of value in life. He valued those things that money can neither buy nor destroy to a certain extent. He valued human relationships. He valued his relationship with the ocean and with his lifestyle, with his ability to play in the ocean. And these attributes, I think, are very special.